Hello, and welcome to TI Precision Lab's Protecting Against Overvoltage Events in PLC AIO Modules. In this video, we will discuss how to protect your analog input module from overvoltage events using TI fault-protected multiplexers. This video is assuming basic understanding of overvoltage protection. For more information, please look at video 210, What is Overvoltage Protection in this series. We will start by discussing the basics of implementing a multiplexer in an AIO module. Next, we will view an example of a fault-protected mux in an AIO module and its subsequent fault response time. We will conclude by looking at input voltage tolerance of fault-protected multiplexers. The goals of this video are to understand operation of fault-protected multiplexers and how input voltage tolerance is calculated. And PLCs exist in harsh industrial environments. These environments can create undervoltage or overvoltage events that can send unintended voltage down a system, damaging or even destroying components like MCUs and ADCs. A TI fault-protected mux can protect against these events and make system design for AIO modules simpler and safer. The fault-protected multiplexer or switch is implemented into an analog input module by placing the IC between the signal input, such as a sensor or external connector, and signal conditioning, like an MCU, ADC, or processor. A mux can either connect one input to one output, as shown here with the TMUX 7462F, or designers can use the TMUX 7308F, which can be used to connect multiple inputs to one output, still protecting all signal paths from fault events while also reducing component count. TI's fault-protected muxes create a high impedance path, turning off the fault channel if an overvoltage condition is measured by the mux. We will next see an example of how overvoltage protection works using a fault-protected mux. The image above shows a PLC analog input module interfacing with a field transmitter to monitor various process sensors at remote locations around the factory. In this case, we can see where an incorrect wiring condition occurred and one of the input connectors has been shorted to the power board supply voltage, causing an overvoltage event. If the board supply voltage is higher, like in this example, 24 volts, then the power supply of the multiplexer, which is 15 volts, then the fault-protected mux, in this case, being the TMUX 7436F, will disconnect the source input from passing the signal to protect the downstream ADC. The drain pin of the channels can either be pulled up to the supply voltage through a 40 kilo-ohm resistor or be left floating depending on the state of the drain pin. This can be configured to match the system requirements on how to handle a fault condition. The TMUX 7436F includes additional overvoltage detection in the form of fault flags, the FF and SF pin. The status of whether an overvoltage condition occurs is indicated by an active low general fault flag. The specific fault flag, on the other hand, can be used to decode which inputs are experiencing an overvoltage condition. Another important characteristic in TI fault-protected multiplexers is the fault response time. The image above shows a fault response time, which measures the delay between the source voltage exceeding the supply voltage by 0.5 volts and the drain voltage falling to 50% of the maximum output voltage. The TMUX 7436F has been measured to have an industry-leading fault response time of 110 nanoseconds. This is important because it decreases the likelihood of overvoltage events damaging downstream components. This feature and many others make the TMUX 7436F or any TI fault-protected multiplexer an ideal solution for factory automation applications that may face various fault conditions but also require excellent linearity and low distortion. The graph to the right shows current TI solutions with detailed information on configurations and other useful information like R-on, C-on, and fault behavior. Some TI fault-protected multiplexers like the TMUX 7436F include additional overvoltage detection in the form of fault flags on the FF and SF pin. Finally, TI's fault-protected muxes all have an input voltage tolerance, which is the maximum voltage that can be applied to any source input pin. The input voltage tolerance is plus 60 volts or minus 60 volts regardless of supply voltage. This allows the device to handle typical voltage fault conditions in industrial applications. All TI fault protected multiplexers are rated to handle maximum stress of 85 volts across different pins, such as the following. Example 1, between the source pins and supply rails. For example, if the device is powered by VDD supply of 20 volts, then the maximum negative signal level on any source pin is negative 60 volts to maintain the 60 volt maximum rating on any source pin. Example 2, between the source pins and one or more drain pin. For example, if the channel connecting source 1 is on and the voltage on source 1 pin is 40 volts, in this case, the drain voltage is also 40 volts. The maximum negative voltage on the source 2 pin is negative 45 volts to maintain the 85 volt maximum rating across the source pin and drain pin. To find more switches and multiplexers technical resources and search products, please visit TI.com.